great matchup for you tonight between the Creighton Bluejays and the Villanova Wildcats. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
There might not be lights in the arena after the game if these two guards shoot them out like they're capable of.
Teams are ready to go, and we're ready for the tip. So here we go. The Wildcats are number 4 in the polls right now.
Hey, Brad, some people like rankings, some people don't. And I'll tell you what, when the polls come out, everyone is looking.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a 4 around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with 4 people on the exterior.
The Wildcats here running their zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Nope. In the lane, gets the J to fall. They'll work it around the arc. He buries the shot. That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
Scorches the net with a J. Here comes a ball screen. For 2, our 3-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Out on the wing. He shoots from the elbow. Buries the sweet fade. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players that have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from the conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
He buries it. He may be in some trouble here. Loose ball, great play. Ball's gonna stay down here. So they'll inbound on the near sideline. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a 4 around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with 4 people on the exterior.
Foster handles the pass. He can put points up, and he can move the ball.
He's the type of player who thrives in almost any offensive system. Very versatile and puts pressure on the defense.
The small forward gets the ball. The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. Here they come now on a turnover. On the outside. Number 5 picks up the foul. Second team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets. You know, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
gets his second. And now getting set up here to four round one.
I tell you, the four round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Goes up for two. Scorches the net. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. The perimeter puts up the tray, can't connect. He bombs from outside, nails a sweet jumper. Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Look at that spacing.
He tries the fall away. He misses the fadeaway. The Wildcats now running a zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Mac. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block.
Nice step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little barista go up in shorts, little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Looking for a good shot. For the way too late with the block. Goaltending. How about this one, Dick?
He took this one strong and hard, Mr. Nestlin. That, my friend, makes a coach proud. Shot usually creates momentum and opportunity.
Now with 10 to shoot. From way outside. Perfectly executed. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Out on the left wing. He shoots from the angle, knocks it down. That one went through the high post, Dick.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nestler. The high post is a gold mine if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
For two, he nails the shot. Looking for a good shot. Ball's going to stay here. On the inbound play. And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Knocked it down. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. The Wildcats running their zone offense here, Dick.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Gave it up. The turn, a fadeaway jumper.
You talk about versatility. There aren't many guys that are going to make that fadeaway jump shot. Great touch. Impossible to block that shot.
Trying to pack it inside. He puts up the J. The missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Gave it up. Tries for two. And we've got a change in possession here. Seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Goes up. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated. I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Shoots.
They're trying to build an entire neighborhood with all those bricks, Brad.
They need some buckets, and they need them in a hurry. Trying to feed the low block. He attempts the jump shot. They got it. We're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on a perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
The Wildcats here running their zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Inside for the bucket. He drains it. Three. Brunson is feeling it right now.
Daddy's on fire.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Number 10 is called for the foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
He may be young, but if he's on the floor for this team, you know he's willing and able to contribute any way he can.
Gets the first. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Second one is no good. Both teams are looking to get something going here. For two, drains the shot. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. Looks at the three. Busts the J. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
They work it around the perimeter. For three, the Wildcats have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Down inside, he takes the shot from the baseline. Can't get the shot to go. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. They work the perimeter. Tries for two. And nice looking jumper in the lane. Number 44 with the ball. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. He gets the board. They work it around the perimeter. Too late. Count the bucket.
That shot's got to come quicker against the zone, Brad.
Here, I'm thinking it was a pretty quick shot the way it was, Dick.
Not quick enough, baby.
Working it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
4 minutes left on the game clock. Goes up for two. Jumper won't go. Joseph receives the pass. Moving it around the perimeter. Launches the three. Missed it. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby. What hops.
Cross court. The fans start to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Three minutes left in the game clock. For the bucket. Comes up empty. Out on the wing.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Here they go in transition. For two, he hits the shot. On the outside.
There's the trap.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Here they go into transition.
Up and inside.
Who wants it? And he saves it. The small forward takes the pass. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. They go into the low block. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Puts up the jumper. Nope. The small forward receives the pass. Now trying to feed the low block. Tries for two. It sticks. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
About a minute remaining. He looks for three. Off the mark. Inside. Pulls up with a jumper and come up short. Shot clock is dead. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Goes up for two. Gets the J to fall. Time running out. Can't connect. At halftime, the Wildcats are trailing by 10. Well, let's take a look at our game summary to this point so far, Dick.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Kicks it out. For the bucket. Bust the jumper. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Bust the J. Fed the low block.
That'll take some pride on the defensive end.
Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. The offense sets up from the sideline. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Trying to feed inside. Goes up with it. The missed shot. The Wildcats set up in their zone motion. They move it into the front court. They'll work it around the arc. Tries a three. Knocks it down. Looking to move it around the perimeter. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Trying to go inside.
For two. Makes the shot. Number 15 gets the pass. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
He shoots the jumper. Knocked it down. On the outside.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Lets it go. Missed the jumper. Turnaround jumper. Jumper won't go. And the jam. Perimeter. He strokes it and he missed. Tries for two. Nails the J.
Look at that spacing. Pressure that basketball.
Brunson receives the pass. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Looking for a good shot. There's a double team waiting there. There's a slam. He shoots from right of the circle. Scorches the net with a J. Let's it fly. Off the mark. Number 10 receives the pass. Looking for a good shot. And a slam. Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. And he misses the shot. The point guard receives the pass. And they come with a double team to stop it. He tries the jumper. Nope. Number 15 gets the ball. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He goes up with it. Gets the J to fall. Swatted away. His shot's blocked.
Hey, he thought he spotted space in that zone, but not today, baby.
On the left side. Controlling the ball. For two. He buries it. They look to get it to the inside.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
He clears some space with a fadeaway. Off the glass and no good. Momentary look from three-point land. Gets the rejection. Gets it to go. They work it around the perimeter. Beyond the arc. They get it to go.
Hey, when a team's hot, they're hot, baby.
The defense putting in a great effort, but it's just not getting it done. They work the perimeter.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. Change of possession. The Blue Jays have been getting it done tonight in a lot of different ways.
I tell you, it can really cause the defense fits and throw you off on offense when a team can play strong across all five positions on the floor.
Ten on the shot clock. Dumps it in. Goes up for two. He gets that one to fall. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
For the bucket, you betcha. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Nails a sweet jumper. Gave it up. 8 minutes left in the game clock. The freshman commits a turnover. Now on the run. The small forward with the ball. Working it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Scores it. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
Brad, those are the type of reads you look for in practice.
Cross court. Here's the three ball. Busts the J. moving it around the perimeter. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
The Wildcats will have to turn to their up-tempo and quick-hitter playbook, Dick, from here on out. Neither time nor score is on their side.
It's all about quick shots now, Brad. They're going to have to get stops and then quick scores to overcome this deficit.
The Blue Jays will probably be better off if they resort to playing in the half court for the rest of the game, Dick. Given the time and score, playing up-tempo really isn't the smartest thing to do.
Preserving the lead should be the primary focus. Continuing to play an up-tempo game wouldn't be very smart at this point.
On the outside.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high-riser.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. They're 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Cross court. From downtown. Can't connect.
Up and inside.
He shoots from left of the circle. Busts the jumper.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He goes for three. Missed the jumper. Number 25 takes the feed.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Jumper won't go.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of them.
Rejects it.
They're trying to work that ball inside, but all they're doing is forcing up bad shots now.
Well, we'll see how long it is before the coach calls a timeout to get everyone back on the same page. He puts up the J.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Cross court. Puts up the J. They got it. They'll work it around the arc. We're at the 4 minute mark. Joseph handles the pass. From right of the circle. Nope. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the three ball. He misses the J. Tickles a twine. The Wildcats did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
Oh, yes, the student body, always full of comedy and excitement.
Outside jumper. The Wildcats have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
We're at the 3 minute mark. A little two man action. Looking to move it around the perimeter. They're off into transition.
He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Well, I'm not sure this is the guy you want to send to the free throw line.
Mentally, he truly believes that he can knock it down. It's a trait that many good free throw shooters have.
Sinks it. Nice pass to the low block. And now the fadeaway jumper. He misses the jumper. On the outside.
Double team now, bad angle.
Bad decision there by the senior. They work it around the perimeter. Jumper off the mark. Number five handles the feed. 2 minutes left on the game clock.
Look at that spacing.
Corner. He clangs the three-point attempt. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
The small forward gets the ball. The Wildcats can't afford. He gets the tough layup and a foul to go with it, Dick.
Hey, that was awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Easy one here. Got it from the free throw line. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around.
And it's blocked. They just keep trying to break through that zone.
But this zone is ready for everything today.
The lead is six.
Hey, a tray here in this place will go absolutely bananas, Brad. I can feel it.
About a minute remaining in the post for two.
They need a basket here to turn this into a two-possession game.
Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
As you guys know, free throw shooting becomes very important down the stretch. The coaching staff is aware of this, and we'll be talking about this in the timeout. It'll be up to the players to knock them down.
Nick, what'd you try to focus on during your timeouts?
You know, Brad, I think it's very important. It's essential that you know the time, the score, and the situation, and make sure that every player knows what our options are, both offensively and defensively.
Change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from downtown, and he misses the shot. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
We're about ready to start things up again. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Shot clock is dead. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. To the charity stripe. Hits that one. Second one, no good. And we'll get a change of possession. I get a feeling they've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Foul them early and give your team a chance. Possession game.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a first guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And before we go anywhere else, let's check in and look at our players of the game.
It was great to see these two kids get after it here today. It always makes the game more interesting when you have competitors like this playing on opposing teams.